Shalom to everyone. We are learning today Zeresh Mishon Parashat Vayishlach in Lera Yud Gimel Pet Shin Mem Tet. Shlomo HaMelech in Mishlei says, Ben Chacham Yismach Av. When you have wise son, then father is happy. Uven Kisil Tugat Imo. But when the child is a fool, it's a sorrow of the mother. I don't understand. Why when child is good, father is happy? When child is bad, sorrow of the mother. Mother is sad. But I didn't say father is sad. My father used to say in Bukharan language, anytime you do something good, they give praise to your father. Father Adman Ahmad. You do something bad, they curse your mother. Why praise goes this side and curse goes the other side? What's going on here? Really? Shlomo HaMelech said it. Whenever child is good, father is happy. Child is not good, mother is sad. Why? There's two deep points there Hashem Shon gives today. Let's see inside and we'll see the answer.
I thought it was a Bukharian thing.
Yes, Ladakdek. Let's analyze. Lama beven chacham amar yismach av. Why on a smart boy, smart son, it says happiness of the father. Ubeven kesila oneshu shel imo. And the child is fool. The punishment goes to the mother. Vez lomar. And the answer is shaben chacham mosif shevach aviv. Because the wise son adds a praise to the father. People say, wow, padar adar achmad. Thanks to your father for raising like this son. Because the father puts him in the proper path. But the fool adds more and more headaches and sorrows and pain to the mother. To the mother, leimo davka. To the mother. Because Rashi says, Allah v'shalom, al pasuk, regarding the pasuk, we all know this pasuk. And Devorah died. She was a midwife. Actually, Meneket is not midwife. It's like a second mother. How do you call second mother? Stepmother. Stepmother. She was a stepmother of Rivka. Devorah was taking care of Rivka when Rivka was baby. When Devorah died, it says, Vatamot Devorah, and Devorah died. I don't understand who else died that day. Who else died that day? Rivka died. Rivka that died day. But it talks about Devorah. Why Torah mentions death of Devorah, but not death of Rivka? So here, Zeresh Shimshon answers. Nitbasel sham, be'evel sheni. Yaakov Avinu heard over there, the second avelut. One for Rivka, one for Devorah. Shehugad lo alimo shemeto. When he was avel, when he was keeping mourn for Devorah, he got message about his mother passing. Ulfikach he'elimu et yom amita. Therefore, the Torah covers up the day of death. Kedei shelo yikalkulu abriyot. So people don't curse. The death of Rivka was covered. Why? So people don't curse. Keres she'etza mimeno esau. The stomach, where Esau came from, people would curse. And they say, whose coffin is this? Right? They say, Rivka. Rivka? Esau's mother? Since from this stomach this baby came out, curse should be. They would curse. Why? Because the terrible child, pain to the mother, even the day of death, is not comfortable for that person. Even that is not nechama. A person is not calmed even by the day of death. And therefore Rivka said to bury her in the middle of the night. Nobody should see her. Why? So people don't curse her coffin. Don't curse her where Esav came from. Stomach.
But they would have blessed her for Yaakov.
Afa katuv lo pirsema. Even the pasuk did not reveal it. What? When from one house two different elements come out, more eyes look at the bad thing than a good thing. This is why. And even though you would say you're right, let's people bless for Yaakov. That's the whole point. Yaakov is not at home. Yaakov was on the road. If he would be in the house, different story. Different story. Yaakov was not at home. וכן מצינו לעניין הטובה דקמה הקרא בברכות שדיים ורחם. And also regarding the blessing, Torah says, oh, should be blessed the... woman's where the child drinks milk from, and the womb that this kid came out from there. ואמרו זאו, and Chachamim said, "Hitbarchun dadeh dadin yaniku." Her place where the child drinks milk from should be blessed because they feed like this kid. Ulchen shapir kama. Therefore, it said beautiful. Oben ksil tugatimo, that when child is full, it's a sorrow to the mother. Why? Because he drank from her. He was nourished by this mother. Share mitad Yitzchak katva b'Torah. But when Yitzchak Avinu passed away, Torah mentions. V'lo chash lo shum davar. Torah was not worried about nothing. Ah, Esav will be walking there. Yeah, people will curse nothing. Rivka, Torah is worried about it. Why Yitzchak passed away, Esav was walking, nobody said anything. Nobody was worried. Aval al mitad Yimka chash hakatu. To teach us that when the child is bad, child is full, the pain is to the mother. The odd, and also, Shamru Zal, Beperek Ben Sorer More, as Chachamim said in Perek Sorer More, Sanhedrin, page 70b, Divrei Lemuel, I'll tell you one thing. Guys, listen carefully. No matter how much smart you could be in the world, no matter how much rich you could be in the world, no matter how much genius you could be in the world, if person does not know his measures, it's terrible. It's terrible. Shlomo HaMelech, at the beginning of his kingdom, he a little bit lost himself. He was drinking a lot of wine. The wisest man in the world. Gemara says, Rashi quotes over there, Rashi says, Shlomo HaMelech would drink a lot of wine. And he says to himself, like, I have so much fun. Lama lanu el. Why do we need God? When you genius men have no boundaries, terrible, dangerous. He says, Lama lanu el. Why do we need God? I drink, I eat, just drink every day, wine every day. Why do we need that? Until his mother came. What was his mother's name?
Bathsheba.
She took him, and what she did? She tied him to the pole. And she gave him nice. Okay? Huh? No, they good. Google.
Google.
That was on the beam. Koi Google. Tied him on the beam. Okay. So, therefore, Torah, Gemara mentions Shlomo HaMelech's name from the. Where is that from? Therefore, Shlomo HaMelech's name is mentioned as a Lemuel from the word Lama Lanu El. Why do we need God? As if to say, like person, when he loses himself, it's a problem. Divrei Lemuel Melech. The words of Lemuel Melech, Melamed, Shekaftoto Imo Ala Omot. His mother tied him up on the beam. Amrelo. She said to him, Mabri. What kind of son do I have? She said, what kind of child did I give birth to? What kind of child came out from me? What kind of child was feeding and raising? Why? Excuse me, what, it only came from you, not the father. That's the whole point. When child is a fool, it's a suffer to the mother. Mother's pain, yes.
I have a problem with this understanding because
I also
three partners in creation. That's Shem, right. The father, the mother. And then secondly, how is the mother responsible for the Yetzirah of the child? He's supposed to overcome and control himself.
Thank you very much. What's your name, Rabbi? What's your name?
Uriel.
Rabbeinu Uriel. Give me a minute. Let's go to the second side and we'll see everything makes sense. If mother was pregnant, eating not kosher food, she was feeding this kid all the garbage in the world. What do you plant? This is what you get. We get there. We get there very close. Let's go further. Huh? Doesn't answer the question? We go step by step. Who said that? Huh?
Throwing him under the bus.
Elisha ben Acher, you taught us that.
What?
Elisha ben Acher.
Elisha Acher? Yeah, why he became Acher?
Because.
Because of what?
His father.
His father? What happened to his father?
That doesn't mean it's only that.
No. What happened to his father? What happened to his father? And what happened to his mother?
I didn't read that page.
Ah! What mother happened? An Yom Kippur. What happened to An Yom Kippur when she was pregnant? An Yom Kippur, where are you going to get kosher shashlik? She was eating pig that was on the way to the... Avod Hazara place, so people should go to do Avod Hazara in order to eat this pig. They would eat the pig and go to Avod Hazara. And she passed by, huh?
But that's after she was pregnant. This is when the man is with his wife. That came first before the
cause and effect.
One second! David HaMelech. Did his father have thought that that was his mother or was the maidservant? What he was thinking? Mitzvah. What's the psak halacha we hold? Psak what says? Men's kavanot does not ruin child. Even though there's machloket, what Joseph brings this in Agadah Shel Pesach. In that book of Agadah Shel Pesach, quotes it says, we see from here, father's thoughts does not ruin the child. But we see from here, mother's food does ruin the child. Why? Because the craving of the child that gives to the mother, knowing that it's not kosher food. Why am I saying knowing? Because An Yom Kippur you're not allowed to give to pregnant woman to eat unless you whisper to her
ear.
And after whispering to the ear means you're talking to that child directly. And if he still doesn't care, he says, I want food and I don't care about Yom Kippur. Already from the stomach it shows that he's dirty kid.
So how is that the mother's fault?
Huh?
So why is that the mother's fault?
She's feeding him.
So what should she do?
She didn't eat yet. Let's say she did not eat yet, but he has those cravings.
It started from the beginning.
It's not a big deal. She doesn't eat, there's no poison. She ate, there's a poison. Rabbi Aaron, thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. Let's go further. Now, Gabriel, I'm sorry. When I was jumping, the fire of poison. I understand you could see whatever you want. Then just prove me how David HaMelech is kosher then.
He may think of a different woman, but he wasn't thinking about improper thoughts, no?
Thinking about different women? It's not like thinking improper thoughts? Who said to you that?
If you know you're with that woman and thinking about that woman, it's not as bad as thinking like about 10 different women and actions you want to do with those 10 women.
Let me tell you something. When a person gets married, and he is doing the mitzvah between him and his wife, it is so important that even one drop thought is not there, it touching and ruining Hashem's name, because we spoke 10 times, man is letter Yud and woman is letter Hey. You're ruining Yud K. Explain to me that point where David HaMelech's father thought of different women and it's still okay according to you. Unless we say what? Father's thoughts does not make a child possible. Let's go further. Hakol Yodim, fourth line from that chapter on the bottom. Hakol Yodim she'avicha yireh shamayim hu. Oh, Rabbi Daniel, thank you for coming. Thank you for yesterday, thank you for today. Look what it says. Bathsheba, she tied up Shlomo HaMelech, her son, king. Can you imagine? King. Today, a child could be even a simple, not even boss, a manager If his mom ties him up into the beam, you know what happens to her? Guys, I don't want to tell you.
Jail.
What is he going to do to his mother? Yeah. Mommy, he embraced me in front of my people. Shlomo HaMelech, king of people, king of demons, king of birds. King! Okay. His mother tied him up on the pole, says, Gee, Sinok, Chotimayim Porchish, why are you ruining my name? Why are you ruining that? You were born from me. I raised you. What are you doing? How are you acting? Look, you got scared. She said, everybody knows your father is tzaddik. Everybody knows your father is tzaddik, David HaMelech tzaddik. But the problem is me. You're not acting properly. What people will think about me? That me is bad. That I'm the problem. Everyone knows that your father is fear of God. Achshav yomru imo garmalo. Now people will see you, Shlomo HaMelech, walking around, eating shish kebab, drinking wine every day. What they will say? What they will say? Who caused them to be corrupted? Your mother. That's a problem. That's what I'm scared for. Because it says, again, I'll start the pasuk for those maybe who missed out on the pasuk. Pasuk says, Ben Chacham Yismach Av. A child is genius, smart, wise, father's happiness. Ben Kesil, child is fool, Tugat Imo, the sorrow of the mother, suffering of the mother, the pain of the mother. And I say, why doesn't the father? According to Shlomo HaMelech, his mother saw he was not acting properly. She said, you doing Averot, people know your father is Tzaddik. So they'll say, ah, it's coming from his mother. So they blame me. Let's go further. Yomru imo garmalo, tzarich tam, lama davka yomru she imo garmalo. Now, your question, guys, I don't understand. What does it do with mother only? Why you say only mother caused him? But lama davka yivar fashin shadaim. And why when they bless, they say what? Bless should be the place where you drink milk from. Ve'es lomar. The answer is, the garsinan beperekaba. The sota dav yudbet amud bet. It says in Gemara, Sotah page 12b, Ha'elech ve'karati lach isha meneked mina ibriyot. What happened with Moshe Rabbeinu? Moshe Rabbeinu, his mother put him in the basket, right? Basket went to the Paro's house. And then Paro's daughter picked him up. As she touched the basket, what happened to her? She cured, right? Now what happened to her? She was taking Moshe Rabbeinu and giving to other mitzriyot so they should feed him. We said what? If woman eats not kosher food and she feeds the baby, baby gets affected from not kosher food, and this is why he's acting in life. And therefore it says what? Sorrow of the mother. Why Ben Chacham Yismach Av? This direction goes. Huh? Child is good, Padarat Barachmat. Child is bad, sorrow of the mother. They curse the mother. Why? Because she gave from her meat to the baby, blood to the baby, skin to the baby, right? Bones come from father. But meat, blood, that every day she eats, she gives flesh to who? From who flesh comes? Flesh comes from the mother. Ha'elech v'kadat lach isha meneket min ha'ivliyot melamed sheikh izrato al kol ha'mitzliyot v'lo datza linek. What happened? Moshe Rabbeinu's Paro's daughter was taking Moshe Rabbeinu to every mitzri woman to feed him. Moshe Rabbeinu said, I'm not going to drink. Really? What do you think? He didn't want to drink? He's yelling. Of course he wants to drink. But you know what Hashem said? I'm not letting you drink. Yomarak Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Hashem said, Peshe atid ledabel imi yenek davar tameh. The mouth that will be talking to me in future now should drink milk from not kosher woman? Uh-oh. V'hainu dichtiv et mi yore de'a. It says, and who will be teaching the knowledge? And who will be teaching the knowledge of Torah? Moshe Rabbeinu. Once Moshe Rabbeinu will be teaching the knowledge, and he will be talking to Hashem directly. He's not allowed to drink from not kosher woman. From Goya. Lemi yore de'a. Lemi shehu gemul mechalau. Who will have zechut to learn from Hashem, Torah, and to teach Torah? A person who is clean from the even mother's milk time. From the milky time. Lemishehu gemul mechalav. he's clean from the milk. Even the milk that you drink is clean. Therefore, the reason Moshe Rabbeinu couldn't drink from Mitzriot. Shenigmala imo veshamra atzma melechol davar tameh. A person who will be learning Torah from Hashem and teaching Torah to people is only who? Whose mother was protecting herself to not eat not kosher food and feeding her child. Not feed her child not kosher food. That she will eat only kosher food and feed her child only kosher food.
Does that apply to kosher?
Huh?
Does that apply to like baby food?
Definitely. Definitely. Any baby is Jewish, must eat kosher food. There is no psak I've never seen in my life that baby should eat not kosher food. And today, Baruch Hashem, we have on Pesach issues, questions. If baby can't, then they say give infant a certain infant because child cannot take different one because of health reasons. But that was 10 years ago. Now, Baruch Hashem, with the all these Arons and all these stores open up, there's a lot of everything kosher today. Yes?
Question. Moshe Rabbeinu had to eat. Paro's daughter gave her to different ladies who are not Jewish.
Yeah.
And Hashem said, don't eat, right?
Hashem said, I'll not let you eat, yes. I will not let you eat. Yeah.
So how come Hashem doesn't tell the ladies on Yom Kippur, I won't make you hungry, or you will not want to eat, or you will not, sometimes pregnant women want to eat something that they eat once when they were not religious.
I'm not trying to touch any child that's going to be born, but he won't be like Moshe Rabbeinu. This law does not apply.
But
that's the answer.
Any other Jew, any other prophet, his mother would be able to eat. She would be allowed to eat. Moshe Rabbeinu is unique. We have five levels of neshama. Nefesh, ruach, neshama, chaya, yechida. The only person who had all these five in him, that's only Moshe Rabbeinu. Yes.
This pasuk is saying someone that's from baby age, that's feeding on the mother's breast milk, is going to have the honor to teach Hashem's Torah.
Mm-hmm.
We have someone like Rabbi Akiva in the Torah. He came from converts who was not kosher before, but then converted to.
His father converted, right?
So we have other examples.
But Moshe Rabbeinu is a unique case. You cannot ask on Moshe Rabbeinu.
I'm not saying on Moshe Rabbeinu, but I'm saying if someone is able to become a.
Can you give him a couple of
things?
Water?
Coffee, water, Coke, or
Coke.
Coke.
Yeah,
Coke. Or
Snapple. Someone's able to come back to Judaism, to become a whole teacher, to become great, but they can't teach him.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. When person... Okay. We're not talking about Moshe Rabbeinu, right? Any other Baal Teshuva. Anybody. His mother ate pig all 50 years. He ate pig 20 years. His father was selling and eating pig 30 years. And he makes teshuvah. Hashem accepts him as if he was born now. And as if he kept all the mitzvot and everything. And he's the highest level. Because he tried, tasted, and he held himself and made teshuvah. This is more than anything. Okay? Thank you. And this is the reason why it says in Yirmiyah, Beterem tetze meleshet hikdashticha melechem. Sorry. Before you came out from the womb, I made you holy. Who is this talking about? Moshe Rabbeinu. Before he came out from the womb, Hashem made him holy. She'asiti she'imcha lo teta'em davar tameh. I made your mother that she should not eat nothing tameh, impure. Kmo shamru zal. As our Chachamim said in Gemara Yevamot, page 99b. Hashta b'emtan shel tzadikim, ena kadosh baruch hu mevi tekala al yadam tzadikim atzman al achad kam b'chama. Tzadikim's animals, Hashem did not make them make mistakes, sin, eat not kosher, so how much more for tzadikim himself, yes.
What if, like, back to the question where you said of mother, like, let's say she didn't grow up being, like, religious, she was not in, like, in a religious, like, area, or, like...
A person who... Let's say person's mother did whatever she kept, kosher, not kosher, meat, milk, chicken, not chicken, pig, not pig, right? He makes teshuva, he says to himself, from today on, I'm not going to do this and this, that's all. He was born today. Hashem says, I consider you were born now. Whatever you did to today, I forgive you. But don't repeat those actions. Go on with it. Go on with your growth.
Yeah, but tomorrow you're going to do it again. Let's say. Then what?
How can I see this guy better? Can I see?
I'm right here.
Okay. I'll explain you one thing. When I was becoming religious, close to 21 years ago, I had this problem myself. How can I stand Yom Kippur or any Shabbat, any Sunday, any Monday, any Tuesday in front of Hashem? Hashem, I promise you, I'm going to sin again. 3 days later, I sin again. 4 days later, 5 days, I sin again. I fall. Nobody's angels, right? Oh, how do you sin? From sinning to sinning, there's difference. Before you sin, you're thinking, that's a mitzvah, let's do it, let's enjoy it. Now, you feel bad, you don't want to do it. You fight with yourself. You fight 1 hour, 2 hours, 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days, and then eventually you fall. You don't want to fall. Hashem knows this. Hashem sees how your fight was. And by this fight, Hashem gives you reward. And Hashem says, I know how you did this sin. You didn't want to do this sin. And therefore, I consider your teshuvah as teshuvah. Now you have to go to do again teshuvah. And your sin is not, oh, that's why I have to do teshuvah if I do sin again. No. How did you do the sin? That's the question. Did you do it enthusiasm or it happened by accident? Now, Gemara will open everything right now, clear. Look what Zeh Shemshon says. Mechen Amru. And also they said in Gemara, page 83a. Zoru Reshaim Merechem. Rasha goes wrong already from the mother's stomach. From the womb. He's already. Who is the best example? Last week's Pasha?
Esav.
She'imam ochelet devarim temeim. Their mothers eating not kosher food. And this is what makes him juke into his head. And now he becomes rasha gamur from the mother's stomach. For those who understand English, and not for the kids, when Esav was born, not only he wanted to kill Yaakov in the process, he took everything with him. So there should be no other brothers coming into the world. For those who understand English. Huh? One say kicked, one say he took everything out with him. Okay, whatever.
Huh? He took the house.
He eat, he drank. He drank all the blood. He drank and this way became like a... Like a beast. Red. Hairy. That's right, thank you. Since mother eating not kosher food, it makes child not kosher. And even though and the wise child, gam imo, also his mother, she has certain enjoyment, right? Therefore, any wise child will give some praise to the mother as well. Why? Because she kept kosher. She kept proper food. She was behaving good. What it says in Pirkei Avot? Rabbi Yehoshua ben Hananya. By the way, Lawaja, is he here? We went to visit Rabbi Yehoshua ben Hananya. Rabbi Elezer ben Arach, Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, they're all in one group, in one place. Yes. Rabbi Yosef ben Hanania, Ashrei Yoladeto. A fortunate is the one who gave birth to him. Why? She kept herself, her mouth holy. Child became holy. Mikol Makom, anyway. Rabbi Yosef ben Hanania's mother. Mikol makom, Amar HaKatuv Yismach Av. Still, what says Pasuk? Smart child, happiness of the father. V'lo Yismach Em. V'lo Yismach Em. Nami, why? Mishum, Debamakom HaIsh, En HaIsha Chashuva L'Klum. But guys, don't repeat this statement at home. For safety reasons. It says in the place of man, woman is not worthy. Therefore, it says, when child is the best, wise, We praise the father, including the mother. But we don't say mother when there's father. It says in Zohar, Batar, the Ishtekach, Dochar, Afilomeo, Nukve, Dochar, Karin, and Lakula. If there is 99 women, one man, we say, oh, you all men are good. 99 women, one man, we say, all of you great men, great men. What do you mean? In the place of men, 100 women considered like secondary. Guys, don't get it wrong. When you go home, the way you have small, keep it. Please. Safety is my goal. When you go to sleep, you know. Okay. Let's go for it. But oh, guys, I'll tell you one thing. We, Jewish men, Hashem's wife. Our wife is our wife. Hashem says, the way you treat my wife, I'm sorry, the way you treat your wife, I will treat you. If you treat your wife with respect, Hashem treats you with respect. But if you abuse your wife, you say anything words, which is chas v'shalom, no, nobody who's sitting here does that. I'll tell you, yesterday I saw, during the shiur, I saw the respect each man gave to his wife. Unbelievable. Yesterday in shiur, I was like, Baruch Hashem, the derech eretz, the kavod, thank you. It's very important. Kids don't learn from what you say. They learn from what you do. It's very important. Bottom line. Ve'od, b'derech acher yuvan ha'pasuk. Also in different way, pasuk is explained. Listen to this pshat now, chidush. Like a brisket Torah a little bit. Let's see. B'ameh she'amru b'ma she'amru b'masachet chidushim perek kama. Ha'av, it says in Gemara Kiddushin, first chapter, page 29b. Tanu Rabbanan, Torah says, Hu lilmod uvno lilmod. You have to learn Torah and your son have to learn Torah. Who is first? Whose Torah learning comes first? I don't know a little bit, my son doesn't know a little bit. What should I do? Should I pay the rabbi to teach me Torah or should I pay the rabbi to teach my son Torah? Who your comes son. First?
You.
Huh?
Father.
Who says son? Who says father?
Father.
You say son. He says father.
The father to teach us.
I would say the son's going to heaven. The father is a.
Yeah, but if he's big rabbi and I don't know nothing, it's also a problem. Huh? Who comes first?
Should the father teach his son?
Depends. Why depends? Who is the son? And who is the father? Let's see. What it says Gemara? Who called him livno? Tarabana. Who lilmod uvno lilmod? Who called him livno? You come first, then your son. Ve'im hayabno zaliz umutzlach ve'talmudomit kayem beyado. But if his son is fast, and he's successful, and whatever he learns he has in his brain, he's like machine, remembers everything. Son comes first. Son is... Who's there? You teach him 50 times! It was the 51st time. And father gets with once, who comes first? Father comes first. But what if son is genius? Son comes first. But no kodmo, ad kam leshono. Va'amar ha'katuv. Look how he explains this. Ah, and the pasuk says, "Ben Chacham, wise son, afapi she'ayot tzarich she'it akev milelech lelimud bishvilo. Wise son, even though father has to stop, not continue going to learn Torah for himself, but son goes. Lefi she'u chariv v'talmudo mitkayem beyado. Son goes to learn because son is genius, and whatever he learns, he stays with him." His good memory, even though my son learns Torah, he grows and father doesn't grow, still father is happy. Why? Because smart son, happiness of the
father.
Aval, but, beben kesil, what if child is fool? As in av kol kach atzvut. Father is not so upset. Why? Because when son does not understand, doesn't want to learn, wants to waste time, doesn't want to gain, doesn't want to grasp Torah, who has to go to learn?
Father.
Who has to go to learn?
Father.
Mother at night stays home with the father or she stays home alone?
Alone.
she stays home alone. Why? Because father went to learn. Father could have stayed home. Father has to learn now. Look what it says. Look what it says. Mipnei she'az holech ba'atzmo lilmod. Since father goes to learn on his own. Aval ha'em yoshevet aguna ki ba'ala shu av tzarich lelech lilmod. Vezeu ben kesil tugat imo. Since father has to go to learn, she stays like a widow at home. Father is not home, suffering of the mother. So therefore, foolish child causes father and mother not to be together. Instead of them staying home and spending time, he has to go all day, he has to work. At night when he has to stay home with his wife, he has to go to learn. Why? Because son cannot learn, so he has to go to learn. So therefore, mother looks like a widow. Therefore, it's suffering to the mother. This is another way to understand the pasuk. What do we try to get here? We try to get one thing here. One simple thing. Yesterday, I said it 5 times, but I think I didn't get it clear. The success of children is the eyes of their fathers. You know, somebody told me something very smart. Very smart. I never told in my life. You know the picture, right? Picture frame. Yeah. Picture of the man. When you look at the picture, who does he look at? He looks at you, right? What if 100 people look at him? What do they think? He looks at everyone, right? He looks at him. This is father's eyes. Father's eyes like a picture. Children don't know what to value in life. How do they know what to value? What my parents value. If my father values somebody who looks at, whoa, look how this kid respects his parents. Did you see how his father got a beautiful tefillin? Did you see the beautiful mezuzah? Did you see beautiful tzitzit? The view of holy things in the child's eyes is like worse than anything, more than anything. What if father sees and says, oh, did you see the neighbors? They got new Rolls Royce over there. What child thinks now? The main thing in life is the best thing to have a good Rolls Royce. Or some other nonsense. But when person views with his eyes, values the honor of Torah, his kids value this. And this is what Torah tries to teach us. If you mother, while you're pregnant, even before pregnancy or even after pregnancy, you're eating not kosher food, you value not kosher food by putting juke into your son or daughter, and then they grow up and they give you birth to them and then they give you a hard time, what do you expect? You're the one who put that thing there. But if you value holy things, kosher food, child becomes Kadosh Hashem. Listen carefully, guys. You know, sometimes I often think I'm like that picture. Everybody looks at me, thinks, oh wow, Rabbi is touching me again. He's talking about Chas V'Shalom. You have no idea. I speak in shul. Everything that hurts me, whatever I see sometimes in public, because I know in my shul we don't have it. If I would know we have these problems, I would never mention this in shul. I want to thank every individual sitting here, starting from small kid to the oldest person here today. You have no idea how much I owe you. Thank you. I changed the day today. We should have learned on Tuesday. I had something very important to be tomorrow in. So I had to change the day and you still came. You still came. Thank you. Thank you. Rabbi Gabriel supported the one part of the shiur because it's his son's today, 3 years old. Haircut. Yitzchak Yosef should become big Talmid Chacham. Amen. 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 Rabbi Michael, he sponsored second part of the shiur, Yakubov, Melo Michael Moshe Ben Yosef, Hashem should give him refuah shlema, v'cheni latzom nomar amen. And also, family of Tamara Pinchasov, Rabbi Daniel, they sponsored today mezonot for the refuah shlema. Alelu nishmat Rabbi Daniel Ben Miriam, gam kol haniftarim haniftarot, ruach Hashem tenichem b'gan Eden. And Hashem should give refuah shlema for kol amo Yisrael, v'cheni latzom nomar amen. Thank you very much for everyone coming. Rabbi Tzion today with us. More often, once a month, we'll make a trick. Hashem should give everyone ברכה והצלחה פרנסה טובה וכן ירצון ונאמר אמן.